ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳೇ ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರು ಮಹೇಶ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ರಸಾಯನಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸಕರು ಮಹಾರಾಣಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರಿ ಪದವಿ ಪೂರ್ವ ಕಾಲೇಜು ಎನ್ಎಸ್ ರೋಡ್ ಮೈಸೂರು ನಾನು ಈ ದಿನ ನಿಮಗೆ ಪಿ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀನಿ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಪಿಯುಸಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ 13 ಮತ್ತೆ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ 14ನೇ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ YouTube ಚಾನೆಲ್ ನೋಡಿ ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಸೋ ದ್ವಿತೀಯ ಪಿಯುಸಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ 15 ಗ್ರೂಪ್ 16 ಗ್ರೂಪ್ 17 ಮತ್ತೆ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ 18 ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು ನಾವು ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ದಿ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ 15 ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ 15 ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ 5 ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ 5 ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ Its symbol is N, phosphorus, its symbol is P, arsenic, its symbol is As, antimony, its symbol is Sb, and bismuth. Symbol is Bi. These are the 5 elements which are present in the group 15. First, let us look at the occurrence of these elements. First one, nitrogen. So, it occurs as a diatomic gas and it makes about 78% by volume of the atmosphere. It also exists in the form of nitrate in the earth crust like sodium nitrate called Chile salt petre. And potassium nitrate. So, Indian salt petre. Nitrogen is also present in amino acids, proteins, and nucleic acids. ನೋಡಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ನು ಡಯಾಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತು ವಾತಾವರಣದಲ್ಲಿ 78% ಬೈ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅದಲ್ಲದೆ ಭೂಮಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ನೈಟ್ರೇಟ್ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ನೈಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಚಿಲಿ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಪೆಟ್ರೆ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಪೊಟಾಸಿಯಂ ನೈಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಪೆಟ್ರೆ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಇದಲ್ಲದೆ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅಮೈನೋ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ಸ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಕಮ್ ಟು ದಿ ಫಾಸ್ಪರಸ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪರಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋ ಹಾಗೆ ಇದು ತುಂಬ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಹೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಇನ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಇದು ಫ್ರೀ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗಲ್ಲ ಬಟ್ ಫಾಸ್ಪರಸ್ ಅಕ್ಕರ್ಸ್ in minerals of the apatite family so general formula Ca9PO46 times and CaX2 x may be F Cl or OH so if x is F fluorine then that is called fluorapatite. If X is Cl, then that is called chlorapatite. If X is OH, then that is called hydroxapatite. So, these are the essential components of rock phosphate. So, apart from these, phosphorus is also present in milk and egg. In the form of phosphoproteins and it is also present in bones and teeth. Okay, when we come to arsenic, antimony and bismuth, these elements are present in traces in the form of sulfide minerals. Sulfide minerals. So, this is all about the occurrence of nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. Now, let us look at the properties like atomic properties, physical properties and also chemical properties of these elements. First, atomic properties, atomic properties. First, let us look at electronic configuration, electronic configuration. The valence shell electronic configuration of 15th group elements is NS2 NP3 NS2 NP3. So, here for nitrogen, helium, (2s2, 2p3). For phosphorus, neon, (3s2, 3p3). Argon, so 3d10, 4s2, 4p3. Krypton, 4d10, sorry, 4d10, 5s2, 5p3. And for bismuth, xenon, 4f14, 5d10, 6s2, 6p3. This is all about the electronic configuration of 15th group elements. So, for nitrogen, helium, 2s2, 2p3. For phosphorus, neon configuration, 3s2, 3p3. Arsenic, argon configuration, 3d10, 4s2, 4p3. Antimony, krypton configuration, 4d10, 5s2, 5p3. Bismuth, xenon configuration, 4f14, 5d10, 6s2, 6p3. So, here when we look at the electronic configuration of these elements, here there is a similarity in the valence shell electronic configuration. In all these, there are 2 electrons in s orbitals and 3 electrons in p orbitals. So, it means that s orbitals are completely filled and p orbitals are off filled, makes the electronic configuration extra stable. We know that any element with off filled orbitals or completely filled orbitals are more stable. Here capacity of p orbital is 6. So, here there are 3 electrons, it means that p orbital is off filled. Hence, off filled p orbitals give the extra stability. Okay? Now, second point, that is atomic and ionic radii. On moving down the group from nitrogen to bismuth, covalent and ionic radii increases down the group. Why? Because of the addition of new shell.
So here, when we look at the covalent radius of these elements, for nitrogen it is 70, for phosphorus it is 110, for arsenic it is 121, antimony it is 141, and for bismuth it is 148. Look at the difference between nitrogen and phosphorus. The increase in the covalent radius from nitrogen to phosphorus is very high, but from arsenic to bismuth this increase becomes very small. Why? So in arsenic, antimony and bismuth there are completely filled d and or f orbitals, but completely filled d and f orbitals are not there in the case of nitrogen and phosphorus. Hence we can observe the considerable increase in the covalent radius from nitrogen to phosphorus, and after that increase becomes very small. So now ionization enthalpy. Look here, on moving down the group, ionization enthalpy decreases due to the increase of atomic size. But the ionization enthalpy of 15th group elements is higher than that of the 14th group elements. The order of successive ionization enthalpy as expected is delta I H 1 less than delta I H 2 less than delta I H 3. This is the order of the successive ionization enthalpy as expected is this, is it right? So this is all about the ionization enthalpy, and the fourth one is electronegativity value decreases on moving down the group, that is from nitrogen to bismuth, is it right? This is all about the atomic properties of 15th group elements. Now let us look at the physical properties. Now let us look at the physical properties. So all elements of this group are polyatomic. Nitrogen exists as a diatomic gas, whereas other elements of the group are solids. And on moving from nitrogen to bismuth, metallic nature increases. So nitrogen and phosphorus are nonmetals, arsenic, antimony are metalloids, and bismuth is a typical metal. So then when we come to the boiling point also increases from nitrogen to bismuth, but melting point increases from nitrogen to arsenic and then decreases. This is due to the decrease of ionization enthalpy and increase of atomic size. Okay? So except nitrogen, all other elements of the group exhibit allotropy. This is all about the physical properties of 15th group elements. Now let us look at the chemical properties of group 15 elements. Chemical properties first one is oxidation state. The common oxidation states of group 15 elements are common oxidation states of these elements are -3, +3 and +5. These are the common oxidation states of group 15 elements. The tendency to exhibit -3 oxidation state decreases on moving down the group due to the increase of size and metallic character. The stability of +5 oxidation state decreases and that of the +3 oxidation state increases on moving down the group. Nitrogen exhibit the oxidation states +1, +2, and +4, and phosphorus exhibit +1 and +4 oxidation states in some oxo acids. In the case of nitrogen, all oxidation states from +1 to +4 tend to disproportionate in acid solution. What is meant by disproportionation reaction? Now let us take an example. Here HNO2 nitrous acid. So it gives nitric acid and nitric oxide and water. Look at the example. In the reactant side, nitrogen is there, in which it is in +3 oxidation state. In the product side, there are two compounds containing nitrogen but in different oxidation state. Here in HNO3, oxidation state of nitrogen is +5, in NO it is +2. Is it right? Now, nitrogen reactant side nalli +3 ide adhe product side nalli erdu product ide adre bere bere oxidation state anna hondirtave ee riti adanta reactions na nave enanta karithivi disproportionation reaction anta karithivi. So in the case of phosphorus, all oxidation states tend to disproportionate +5 to -3. In the case of phosphorus, all oxidation states tend to disproportionate into +5 and -3 in acid and in alkali. Here, in the case of arsenic, antimony, and bismuth, +3 oxidation states become increasingly stable with respect to disproportionation reaction. On the other hand, nitrogen cannot expand its covalency beyond 4. Why? because of the non-availability of d orbitals. Hence, nitrogen cannot form. NF5 or NCl5. When we come to phosphorus and other elements of the group, there are vacant d orbitals in their valence shell, and then exhibit the covalency of 5 or 6. Hence, they can form the compounds PCl5, ASF5, PF6 minus SBF6 minus. When we come to bismuth, the only characterized bismuth 5 compound is BIF5. This is all about the oxidation state of group 15 elements. Now, let us move on to the anomalous properties of nitrogen. Anomalous properties of nitrogen. The reasons for the anomalous behavior of nitrogen are, so first let us look at the reasons for the anomalous properties of nitrogen. First one is its small size. Second one, high ionization enthalpy. Third one, high electronegativity. Fourth one, non-availability of d orbitals. So, anomalous properties nitrogen ki ee nalaku kaaranagalu. Nitrogen is having small size when compared to the other elements of the same group. It has high ionization enthalpy and high electronegativity. So, d orbitals are not present in the nitrogen. So, these are the reasons for the anomalous behavior of nitrogen. Now, nitrogen has the ability to form p pi multiple bonds, p pi multiple bonds. With itself and with other elements having small size and high electronegativity. Example, carbon, oxygen. So, with these elements, nitrogen can form p pi multiple bonds. Because of this, nitrogen exists as a diatomic molecule. With a triple bond between nitrogen, two nitrogen atoms. ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎಂಥಾಲ್ಪಿ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಹೈ. ಇದರ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಎಂಥಾಲ್ಪಿ ತುಂಬ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ 941.4 ಕಿಲೋ ಜೋಲ್ ಪರ್ ಮೋಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವ್ ಅದರ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಪಿ ಪೈ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ವೈ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಓವರ್ಲ್ಯಾಪಿಂಗ್. ನೋಡಿ, ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ನು ಪಿ ಪೈ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸನ್ನು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಅದೇ ಬೇರೆ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಗಳು ಯಾವ್ಯಾವುದು, ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್, ಆರ್ಸೆನಿಕ್, ಆ್ಯಂಟಿಮನಿ ಮತ್ತು ಬಿಸ್ಪತ್ತು, ಇವು ಪಿ ಪೈ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ. ಕಾರಣ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಅಂದರೆ, ಅವುಗಳ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸು ತುಂಬ ದೊಡ್ಡದಿರುತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತು ಎಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಓವರ್ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಫರ್ದರ್, ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದಿ ನಾನ್ ಅವೈಲೆಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಡಿ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೇಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೆಲ್, ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಡಿ ಪೈ ಬಾಂಡ್. ಡಿ ಪೈ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ದಿ ಹೆವಿಯರ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ನೋಡಿ, ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್, ಆರ್ಸೆನಿಕ್, ಆ್ಯಂಟಿಮನಿ, ಬಿಸ್ಮತ್, ಈ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಗಳು ಡಿ ಪೈ ಬಾಂಡ್ಗಳನ್ನು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್ಸಿಂದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ಡಿ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸು ವೇಲೆನ್ಶಲ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆದರೆ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ಗೆ ಡಿ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸ್ ಸಿಗದೇ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಡಿ ಪೈ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್, ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದಿ ಅಬ್ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾನ್ ಅವೈಲಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಡಿ ಆರ್ಬಿಟಲ್ಸ್, ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಡಿ ಪೈ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್, ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಅದರ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ 15 ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಡಿ ಪೈ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಸೆನಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಡಿ ಪೈ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಷನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್. ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆರ್ಸೆನಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಡಿ ಪೈ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಷನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಕಾಂಟ್ರರಿ, ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್, ಆರ್ಸೆನಿಕ್, ಆ್ಯಂಟಿಮನಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ SB-SB. ಲುಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ PP ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ಆರ್ಸೆನಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ SS ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಆ್ಯಂಟಿಮನಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದಿ SB-SB ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್, ಬಟ್ ಬಿಸ್ಮತ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದಿ ಮೆಟಾಲಿಕ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಎನ್ ಎನ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ವೀಕರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಪಿ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್. ವೈ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಟರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ ರಿಪಲ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ನಾನ್ ಬಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೈ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ವನ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್. ಹೆನ್ಸ್ NN ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ವೀಕರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ PP ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಕೆಟನೇಷನ್ ಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ ಈಸ್ ವೀಕರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್. ನೌ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, reactivity towards hydrogen. All these elements of group 15 form hydrides. Form hydrides of the type EH3, where E is equal to N phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth. So, where E may be nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, or bismuth. So, here nitrogen form NH3, ammonia. Phosphorus, it is phosphine. Arsenic, arsine. SbH3, stibine. BiH3, bismuthine. Now, let us look at the bond dissociation enthalpy or bond enthalpy. Bond enthalpy or bond dissociation enthalpy. 389, then 322, 297, 255. So, look here, bond dissociation enthalpy for ammonia is very high. So, then for phosphine it is 322 and for arsine 297 and for stibine 255. So, as the bond dissociation enthalpy decreases, stability also decreases. Is it right? Okay, this is the most stable one. Then reducing character, it is nothing but the ability to give hydrogen. It increases. So, ammonia is a mild reducing agent, whereas bismuthine is a strongest reducing agent. Is it right? So, here ammonia is the mild reducing agent and bismuthine is the strongest reducing agent. Now, come to the one more property, basicity. So, here basicity also decreases in the order ammonia, then phosphine, then arsine, then stibine, then bismuthine. Ammonia is a strong base and bismuthine is a weak base. Is it right? So, then here in all these there is a non-bonding electron or there is a lone pair of electrons on nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. Hence, this can also act as Lewis bases. So, here this is all about the reactivity towards hydrogen. Let us discuss the reactivity towards oxygen. Reactivity towards oxygen. All these elements of group 15 form two types of oxides, E2O3, these are called trioxides, and E2O5 pentoxides. E2O3 and E2O5. So, E2O3 is trioxides, trioxide, and E2O5 pentoxides. The oxide in the higher oxidation state is more acidic than that of the lower oxidation state. So, the acidic nature of trioxides decreases down the group. So, oxides, trioxides of nitrogen and phosphorus are acidic, oxides of arsenic and antimony are amphoteric, and oxide of bismuth is basic. So, this is all about the reactivity towards oxygen. Okay. So, now let us look at reactivity towards halogens. Reactivity towards halogens. All these elements of group 15 form two types of halides, EX3, they are called trihalides, and EX5 pentahalides. Here E may be nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony or bismuth. So, here these are the two series of halides, EX3 trihalide and EX5 pentahalide. So, generally pentahalides are more covalent than the trihalides. Generally, so pentahalides of the group 15 elements are more covalent than the trihalides. So, all the trihalides of these elements except those of nitrogen are stable. But when we come to nitrogen, so NF3 is known to be stable. Trihalide, nitrogen na trihalide avdo NF3 idu stable. Trihalides except BiF3 are covalent in nature. Okay. So, look here once again, the all the elements of group 15 form two types of halides or two series of halides, EX3, they are called trihalides, EX5, they are called pentahalides. So, here pentahalides are more covalent than trihalides. Trihalides except those of nitrogen are more stable. So when we come to the nitrogen, NF3 is known to be stable. So trihalides except BIF3 are covalent in nature. Is it right? Now, and the fourth property, chemical property, reactivity towards metals. All these elements of group 15 combine with metals, so exhibiting -3 oxidation state. Example, calcium nitride. Then calcium phosphide. Then sodium arsenide. Then zinc antimonide. And magnesium bismuthide. So here, these are the products of the group 15 elements with some metals. Nitrogen with calcium forms Ca3N2 calcium nitride. Phosphorus with calcium gives Ca3P2 calcium phosphide. So arsenic with sodium gives Na3As sodium arsenide. So zinc with antimony, it will give, so zinc antimonide. So magnesium with bismuth will give magnesium bismuthide. Okay, this is all about the reactivity towards metals. Now let us discuss nitrogen, dinitrogen. Now let us discuss dinitrogen. Dinitrogen is produced commercially by liquefaction and fractional distillation of air. So dinitrogen distills out first because its boiling point is 77.2 Kelvin. So and that of oxygen is 90 Kelvin. So dinitrogen is produced commercially by liquefaction and fractional distillation of air. Nitrogen, which is having the boiling point 77.2 Kelvin, distills out first, leaving behind oxygen, its boiling point is 90 Kelvin. So here, this is one of the commercial method of preparation. In the laboratory, so nitrogen can be obtained by treating aqueous ammonium chloride with sodium nitrite. Sodium nitrite. So look here, N2, it is a gas. N2 is a gas. Then NaCl, it is aqueous, and water, it is liquid. In addition to these, small amount of NO and HNO3, nitric oxide and nitric acid, are also obtained as impurities. These impurities can be removed by passing the gas through aqueous sulfuric acid containing potassium dichromate. Apart from this, nitrogen can also be obtained by the thermal decomposition of ammonium dichromate. Ammonium dichromate. So look here, NH4 twice, Cr2O7, when it is heated, we get N2 plus 4 water plus Cr2O3, okay. This is how we can obtain nitrogen by the thermal decomposition of ammonium dichromate. Pure nitrogen can also be obtained by the thermal decomposition of sodium or barium azide. Sodium or barium azide. Pure nitrogen can be obtained by the thermal decomposition of sodium or barium azide. So, look at the reaction. Heat Ba plus 3N2. This is all about the preparation of dinitrogen. Okay? So, in the commercial way, we can obtain nitrogen by liquefaction and fractional distillation of air. In the laboratory, we can obtain the nitrogen by treating aqueous ammonium chloride with sodium nitrite, and along with traces of nitric oxide and nitric acid are also obtained. These can be removed by passing the gas through aqueous sulfuric acid containing potassium dichromate. So, by thermal decomposition of ammonium dichromate, we can obtain nitrogen. Pure nitrogen can be obtained by the thermal decomposition of barium azide or sodium azide. Now, let us look at the physical properties of dinitrogen. Dinitrogen is a colorless, odorless, tasteless, non-toxic gas. It has a very low solubility in water, that's about 23.2 centimeter cube per liter of water at 273 Kelvin and 1 bar pressure, and it also has low freezing and boiling point. Okay? Now, let us look at the reactivity. We know that dinitrogen is inert at room temperature because of nitrogen-nitrogen triple bond and has high bond dissociation energy. But at high temperature, nitrogen combines with metals to form ionic nitrides and with non-metals form covalent nitrides. So here lithium with nitrogen heat. So here Li3N, lithium nitride. Then magnesium with nitrogen heat at Mg3N2, magnesium nitride, and this is lithium nitride. Okay, so when we come to the reaction with other elements, nitrogen combines with hydrogen at 773 Kelvin in the presence of a catalyst. So, ammonia is obtained. During this, kilojoules of heat is liberated. 46.1 kilojoules of heat is liberated. So, then nitrogen also combines with oxygen at high temperature of about, and it will give nitric oxide. It will give nitric oxide. This is all about the reaction of nitrogen with metals and with hydrogen and also with oxygen. Now, let us discuss uses of dinitrogen. Dinitrogen is used in the manufacture of ammonia, nitric acid, calcium cyanamide. Then, second one, it provides an inert atmosphere in steel and iron industry. Liquid dinitrogen is used as a refrigerant to preserve biological materials, food items, and in cryosurgery. These are the important uses of dinitrogen.